chapter 3, verse 8. So it says, "And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day." And Adam and... that's where I wanted to finish off of. We have come to the house of God to commune with him in the, like, around this time in the cool of the day, which is a blessing. So everybody had a good day. If you had a good day, good day. If you had a good day, okay. George, Kesho will be better. This is the month of rest, and we are in sort of like we were told on Sunday. It's the Garden of Eden was the Garden of Rest. It was the Garden of Rest oration, and so in this garden, during the time of Adam and Eve. When they were in the garden, they were in, Bishop has told us that the Garden of Eden was also a temple. So every evening, the Lord would come down and commune with them and fellowship with them on a daily basis until, you know, until the fall of man. So since that is where we are today, that's where we are in sort of like... the Garden of Restoration. We are here to commune with the Lord, and I'm hoping that that's what we are going to be able to do today. So my message is going to be very short. Mama taught us on Sunday that there are three things that can prevent us from, or that can make us lose our restoration. Can anybody remember the first one? It has to do with this. Yes. It's hunger. Hunger, it's like, she used an example of, you know, selling a whole farm of wheat in order to get a loaf of bread. Okay. The second thing was pride. And the third thing was worship. Worship of idols, worship of... any other thing that is not God. Incidentally, worship is also one of the things that will help us maintain restoration. That is the worship of God. And this is actually what I want us to do today. We want to sort of, there are many people who are here who are not normally with us on Friday. So we want to sort of give a snippet of what we normally do on Friday. We bring it here. So we are going to have a session of this session is going to be, since I'm the host, I've said this will be mostly praise and worship, the same way, the way we do on Friday. And we are the ones, the youth are going to be the ones to lead it. Amen? Okay. Let me open, let's go to Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 8. Verse 7. Let me just read it quickly. So blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord. For he shall be like a tree planted by the waters, which spread out its roots by the river. And will not fear when the heat comes, but its leaf will be green and will be anxious in the year, and will not be anxious in the year of drought, nor will cease from yielding fruit. In most gardens, in most vineyards, you'll always find what keeps the place green and what keeps the fruits regenerating and the trees growing. There is always a river, and all the trees, any tree that is planted next to the river are usually green, and they're usually green throughout the year, especially if it's a river that is permanent. So The Bible says, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord, for he shall be like a tree planted by the waters. In this garden here that we have come to commune with the Lord, the river of life flows here. And if we are connected to the river, if we've plugged into the river, we shall always be green. It shall show from people just looking at you. They shall know that you are different. You know, in and out of season, we can read from Psalms 1 verse 3. Let me start from verse 1. It also says, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Again, it's talking about the same river and the trees that are, you know, planted next to the river. They always bring its fruit in season, and their leaves never wither. When I was preparing for this message, I got a revelation. I got a revelation of a tree that was planted by the river, but its roots were not connected to the river. The roots were moving away from the river to the drier parts. So and I was just thinking about this. I was like, it's so profound that people, Christians, can be at a place where they are standing in the garden where there is a river and the roots are not tapped into the river. So they are facing away from the river. So while that tree will not die because of the moisture, because of the little water it will get through science, it will never be as healthy as the other ones. It will not be as green as the other ones. The leaves will not be as broad as the other ones. The fruit that it produces will not be as much as the other ones. Maybe it will produce smaller fruits than the others. And so, like, I was just thinking of for example, people who have been stuck in religion, who, you know, you are at the river. The river is right there. You're in the garden. The river is right there, but the roots are not, you know, tapping into the river. Even those who are not stuck in religion, but those who, you know, through one way or the other, we feel like we are doing all the right things. We are loyal. You know, you'll find somebody saying, the last time I missed church was 10 years ago. Mi hata nikiwa mgonjwa, you know, I'm very persistent, I'm very loyal. But so that is okay. So you are on the river, you are inside the garden. You participate in all the activities. So you're planted close to the river. However, roots are in, you know, the roots are not connected to the river. Like uko tu hapo kwa edge on the bank, and then the roots are going the other way. And alafu, you know, usually after that, those are the people. They are people now. You will be like, wakiacha, if they leave the faith or they backslide, you'll be like, wow. If there's somebody I never thought would ever do that, would ever leave the faith, would never leave the church. It's this person. But what people don't realize, because the roots are beneath, you don't see where the roots are. The roots could be, you know, could be facing a different side. And that is also another thing that can prevent us from this restoration, from keeping, from maintaining, even when restoration comes, even from maintaining it. Kama the roots are facing a different side. Nishida, it's trouble. It's trouble for us. It'll never be the same. And when, say, somebody's coming looking for firewood, and they're passing by the river, will they start with a tree that is looking like it has huge branches and huge stems and broad leaves, or will they look for that kawan that is, you know, a little bit thin, a little bit small leaves, maybe produces less fruit than the others? Atanzia gani? They'll start with the one that looks, you know, that looks dry, that looks like he already naka inaenda kukufa. So let's meditate on that word and find out and check ourselves and find out where we stand. First of all, are we in the garden of restoration, of rest? Are we communing with God as often as we ought to? Are we by the river, or are we just somewhere else again? Not by the river. We are by the river. Are our roots tapped into the river? Are we constantly being renewed, being refreshed, being refilled, being resurrected, you know? Are we constantly growing and producing good fruit? Not bad fruit, not small fruit, not no fruit, but are we producing, you know, good fruit? That is the word I had, and I would like us to just stand. Since we are here to be in communion with God, that's what we want to do. We want to commune with God in praise and in worship for maybe, you know, as the Holy Spirit leads us. I don't want to put a time on it. So could I ask us to stand? Tayarishe kuimba. So yeah, I know it was a bit of a tough word, lakini tutajaribu ku nini. Watu wangu wa Friday. Msini yangu. Okay. George, uko tayari? Haya. Sifu Bwana, aye. Sifu Bwana,
amefanya majabu, aye.
Sifu Bwana,
aye.
Amefanya majabu, aye. Songeni decide where they say.
What Mike has just told us is in the garden of restoration, we need to take our roots deep so that they get nourishment from the river. And worship and praise is one of the things that will put our roots deep. Okay? So that's why this year we are going to sing. You understand now? So you want your roots to go down? To touch restoration and expansion, then praise Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, yeah.
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 Yesu.
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 Anaweza.
Anaweza.
Jemedari.
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 Ekati kati ya miungu. Sijaona Mungu. Mungu kama yawe nasema Mungu kama yawe
kama wewe
Mungu 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 kama wewe
Mwamba 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 Yesu ndiye mwamba
Yeah.
shundi sasa inapepea
Bendera ya Yesu sasa inapepea
Bendera ya uzima sasa inapepea
Bendera ya Yesu sasa inapepea
Bendera ya uzima sasa inapepea
Bendera ya Yesu sasa inapepea
Nimebadilishwa na fanana naye
Yeah.
tunakurudishia utukufu wako Bwana.
Ndiye, ndiye, ndiye leo tunakurudishia utukufu wako Yawe.
Ndiye, ndiye, ndiye Bwana, tunakurudishia utukufu wako Bwana.
Ndiye, ndiye, ndiye Bwana, tunakurudishia heshima yako Yawe.
mataifa mmeingia. Mataifa mmeingia usiku wa leo. Oh, mataifa mnaingia. Mataifa mnaingia. Mataifa mnaingia. Hey, mataifa mmeingia. Mataifa mtaenda mkicheka. Mataifa mtaingia mkicheka. Oh, mtaingia mkiwa na furaha, mkiwa na shangwe tele. Mtaingia si kwa huzuni na si kwa machozi, ila machozi ya furaha. Machozi ya kurudisha shukrani. Shukrani kwa Mwenyezi Mungu, kwa maana nimetenda. Kwa maana mmeingia kwa kishindo. Mmeingia kwa kishindo. Wala si kwa haya, mmeingia kwa kishindo. Mmeingia kwa kishindo. Hamjaingia kwa haya na hamjaingia kwa aibu. Mmeingia kwa furaha na nidhamu. Mmeingia. Mataifa mmeingia. Mataifa yanajitayarisha kuwapokea. Mataifa yanajitayarisha kuwapokea. Yanajitayarisha kuwapokea. Kuwapokea, kuwapokea, kuwapokea. Ha, mataifa yako tayari kuwakaribisha sasa. Ha, mnaingia na mmeingia. Mmeingia, mmeingia. Na mtaingia na mtaenda mpanuke hata zaidi kule. Oh, mtaenda mkiwa mmoja, lakini mtapanuka. Kama vile Yosefu aliingia akiwa peke yake, lakini walipokuwa wakitoka, walitoka wakiwa wengi, wengi hata zaidi. Oh, Ria Makuza. Hey, alienda akapokea urithi wake. Hata nyinyi mmepokea urithi. Na sasa wakati umefika wa kuanza kuingia mataifa. Sasa wakati umefika hata kwa wale wako mataifani, wapanuke sasa. Wapanuke sasa. Hata kwa wale washatangulia, sasa ni wakati wa kupanuka zaidi, zaidi na zaidi, tena na tena. Oh, nimeamrisha usiku wa leo. Nimeamrisha usiku wa leo. Hata kwa wale tayari waliwatangulia, hata kwa wao kuna kupanuka sasa hivi. Kuna kupanuka. Kuna kupanuka. Kuna kupanuka hata kwa uzazi. Oh, kuna kupanuka hata kwa ndoa. Kuna kupanuka hata kwa kazi. Kuna kupanuka usiku wa leo. Mataifa yako tayari. Ha, sasa mmeingia na nimewaamrisha. Oh, nimeamrisha hata neno langu usiku wa leo. Na nitatenda tena kama vile nilivyowaambia. Kama vile nilivyowaambia, nimekuja kutenda. Na mnaingia kwa kishindo. Mnaingia kwa kishindo.
Tuwasema asante kwa Mungu wa twasema asante kwa wema wako, kwa maana
milele na milele.
Sante kwa Mungu wangu, twasema sante kwa wema wako, kwa maana fadhili zako zadumu mile na milele. Amina.
That even as I walk within you right now, that you may walk out, you may walk out with my power, you may walk out with my spirit, that you may spread out, that I may be the source And even as you drink from the source, that you may resource out. That even as you drink out from this source, that you may bring out to the nations. This is a covenant today that you're making, that you will walk out from this source. This is a covenant that you're making today. That you may not slip away, but you may walk and keep on drinking from this source. That you may come and drink and be filled to the fullest. That you may have fullness of joy. That you may have fullness of grace. That you may have fullness of your my glory. This is a covenant you're making today. Don't get tired of drinking from this source, because I'll never run dry. And I'm pouring out to you to this day.
Tutabaki mbele zako milele Yesu. Tutabaki mbele zako milele Yesu. Tutabaki mbele zako milele
milele.
Amen.
ukikunywa maji haya. Utabaki ukikunywa maji haya. Utabaki ukikunywa maji haya. Milele. Hata kama majira yatabadilika, utabaki ukikunywa maji haya. Hata majira yakibadilika, utakunywa maji haya. Utabaki kunywa maji haya. Utabaki kunywa maji haya. Kwa maana yeye ni Mungu. Yeye ni maji ya uzima. Maji ya uzima. Milele na milele. Tutakunywa maji haya. Tutakunywa maji haya. Tutakunywa maji haya. Maji ya milele, maji ya uzima.
Lord, we give you glory, we give you praise for honoring us with nations. We say like David, we are just but a worm without any value. But you have looked unto us and you have put value in our lives. And this evening we give you glory. We honor you, Lord. I pray that you may cause us to walk steadily. And as we have been told today, allow our roots to go deeper in the garden of restoration, that we may be nourished to a point where we can expand and go out for outreach, Lord. Thank you for the doing this evening. Thank you for your hand and your move in our midst. We bless your holy name, Lord. Even as we go home, give us to be like Mary, to ponder even on our beds the things that you have done today, Lord, upon our lives. We don't deserve. It's just by your mercy and your grace, Lord. We appreciate your love this evening, and we forever worship you for your love upon our lives. Thank you, Jesus. Even now as we go home, go with us. Continue speaking with us and our hearts, even in the night, even in our sleep. Continue connecting us with you, the fountain of the living waters, that our leaves will never fall and we shall bear fruit in the right season. Thank you, Jesus. Be thou lifted high. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we declare we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.